I've been with Dtra since October 1st, 1998. And before that, I was with the On-Site Inspection Agency since 1992.
I started Dtra in October of 2009.
I signed on with the On-Site Inspection team as a treaty escort. I was in uniform. I retired from the Air Force. They hired me back.
I worked for one of the legacy agencies, the Defense Nuclear Agency, and then shortly after I came on board in 95, it changed to the Defense Special Weapons Agency.
I had no idea what Dtra did.
When I first got here, I never realized there's really three aspects of Dtra: the treaty side, the operations side, and then the R&D side. I was taken back by the operations and the R&D side.
When I heard about Dtra, I read about it, and I was like, this would be interesting to be a part of. I've been working here ever since.
I've always worked in the human resources environment, so it was just exciting to see how things were changing. We got to work with the folks in the HR office at the Defense Special Weapons Agency, so it was nice bringing together two different groups of people to support the human resources of the agency.
I see Dtra, I think, expanding our permanent presence overseas. Right now, the sun never sets on Dtra. It's one of those cliches. I think that it'll be increasing based on missions we are undertaking, partnerships we're forming.
First of all, we got good people up in the front office.
The people are really the key to this organization.
That has to remain. Somebody that's connected, that knows the mission and can go out and pitch the mission.
A lot of people don't realize the operational impact we have. We're more than a combat support agency. We are out in harm's way. We're getting shot at. We need to be able to shoot back, if you will. But I think not a lot of people know that we're really out there on the front lines.
The mission here is so exciting, and the tempo is so exciting and dynamic. There's never a dull moment.
Seeing now how the mission affects not only the United States, but the world, it's very eye-opening and very interesting.
With the way the world is running today, we have to have this agency to help combat terrorism and all of that, things of that nature. If you keep the right people and put them in the right position, I think this agency will go far, and I think we'll be around for a while there. I don't think this one will ever be dissolved.